and wanted the furnace seven times harder. Touch your neighbor, tell your neighbor, say, don't use my number. Find one more person to talk to and tell them, don't use my number. If you've done six times, you'd have been okay. Because six is the number, glory to God, of man and flesh. If you'd have used 13, you'd have been okay. Because 13 is the number of disorder and rebellion. But for you to use seven, don't use seven. Because seven is the number of perfected things and completion. You heated it up just enough to complete a miracle in my life. Why don't you talk over to somebody? God, help me in here and tell them, don't use my number. Yes, the Bible says that the same flame that was meant to kill the Hebrew boys came out of the furnace, grabbed them, and incinerated them. And I heard the Lord speak in my ear and say, Pierre, your place of deliverance is a place of death for somebody else. Can you help me preach and tell somebody else for the fourth time and tell them, my place of deliverance is a place of death for my enemy? Because people are dying with what I'm living with. People are blowing their brains out of their head with the stuff I'm standing with. Folks get fired from their jobs and run their cars off of bridges, but with no job, I'm still saying, this is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. The Lord has made. I will rejoice, I will rejoice and be glad in it. Yeah, husband crazy, children crazy, church folk acting up, glory to God. But you say, victory is mine, victory is mine, victory today is mine. Oh, I told Satan, get thee behind, victory today is mine. Yes, God says, it's your place of deliverance, but it's their place of death. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Yes, Lord. Yeah. Look over your shoulder and talk to the neighbor behind you and tell them, hang in there. Can I go a little further and lean on the same verse? That's verse 22. The Bible says, and they took them up. Watch this. The Bible said they took them up. Now the 23rd verse say they fell into the furnace. And the 22nd verse say they took them up. What are you saying, Dr. Bryant? I'm saying that God told me to encourage five people tonight that you didn't get thrown in. You fell in. Because the people who picked you up died before they could push you all the way. God help me here. The Bible says they fell into the furnace because the men that was carrying them got caught by the fire. Can I get out of y'all way? I'm about ready to close here now. But the Lord told me to tell you, you stumbled because of how they dropped you. Yes, Lord. Not because you didn't have power to stand. It's because you was being carried and they fumbled you right at the finish line. They fumbled you in the end zone. But I got good news tonight. Yes, Lord. The Bible says in the 24th verse, glory to God. In the 24th verse, the Bible says that King Nebuchadnezzar looked and leaned forward.
My God.
Jesus.
Glanced over to the other chancellors, lords, dignitaries, and distinguished gentlemen.
Yes, sir.
And said, Did we not throw three men into the furnace? Yes, Lord. But
come on,
Jesus.
Looks like to me there is a fourth man.
I hear you.
In the furnace. Minister me, me, the Lord.
Close it out. Close it out.
Spoke to me and said, keep your head up, Brian. The king is looking.
Well,
I wish I had somebody to talk back to me. He spoke to me and said, VJ, I know you in the front. God, I feel pretty in here. Yeah, you in a hot place. Hold yourself together because the king is looking. The Bible says that the heart of the king is in God's hands. And he turned it any way that he will. Your neighbor and tell him, say, oh neighbor, hold your head up. The king is looking. Do y'all hear me? You can't fall apart now because the king is looking. You can't lose your mind because the king is looking. The towel, because the king is looking to see how you gonna handle it. The God preached right. Lean on somebody. I don't see you leaning. Lean on somebody and tell them, say, the king is looking. Why don't you shout, yes, Lord? Come on, shout, yes, Lord. I heard the Lord speak to me and say, PM, what happened? I said, go on. The bounds. The king said, and their bounds. Not only were they in there, he said, but they were walking around loose. That the bounds had burned off of them. And the Lord told me to tell you that the only thing the fire is meant to do is to free you from what's holding you. Why don't you grab somebody and tell them, say, I got to stay in it long enough to get free from what I was bound with. I got to stay here long enough to get free from what was holding me. Yes. Mary called the song and said, take the shackles off my feet so I can dance. I just want to praise him. Just want to praise him. Want to shout yes. The Bible declared that the fire burned off their bands. Yes, Lord, your bands are coming off in the flame. He's not going to bring you out and then free you. He's going to free you while you're in it. Yeah! It doesn't require. I heard the Bible say, he said, tell them, Brian, from the second to the last time, he said, tell them they're not being tested, they're being quested. If they tell them they're not being tested, but they're being questioned, they are him. Do you know the difference between a test and a quest? Yes, Lord. Know the definite. A test is used to assess current knowledge of what you've been taught or what you've learned. Yes, God. But a quest is a journey wherein we find ourselves while seeking for something else. Did you hear me? God said he's not testing you. He's questing you. He's putting you on a journey to go after something else. But while you're going after that, you're going to find something in yourself. What you're going to find out, that greater is he. Yes, that's in me. That's in the world. He's not testing me. He's questing me. And so I've got to feel after God. Though he be not far from any one of us. He's not testing me. He's questing me. So I gotta seek him first. The kingdom of God and his righteousness. And shuts in here. Shuts in here.